Hello everyone, and welcome to an interview with Adrian Walker. I'm going to be the host, Chess Grandmaster Yasser Seirawan, for the exhibit, The Imagery of Chess, St. Louis Artists. Adrian, pleasure to meet you. Tell us about your art and how it relates to chess.
One of the artists here in The Imagery of Chess, my work is titled Black Rank. And black rank stems from the actual term back rank.
Exactly.
It's a play. Yeah, it's a play. And I don't play chess, but I did study and look up some terms alongside with my wife. She's a huge help. Without her, I probably wouldn't even have this. And so I did like a couple of studies on like what back rank means. Mm-hmm. And my characters here, each character represents a piece, a chess piece. So I have the queen, the king, bishop, knight, rook, and pawn.
And you're the pawn.
Yeah, and I'm the pawn. And this is symbolizes the black family unit. And these are friends of mine back in Oakland, California I met, who I feel play a role in my life as the same people who play a role in my life here in St. Louis from my actual family. And they each symbolically represent somewhat of a member of my family.
But in your piece, you have the female as the king, as the most important figure in the black family.
Yep. My mom was the most important in the family, you know.
Me too.
Yeah, for everybody, I mean. Yeah. They nurture us.
They
give us life, you know. I mean, that's all to be said, you know.
Right.
And so with that, they are, to me, the most dominant
figure
in our lives,
or
whatever. So on a chessboard, it's the same thing to me.
Right.
And that's how I look at the king being the woman.
Right.
Because of roles of what they play in our lives.
And father figure.
Rebecca,
out there earning the money.
Exactly. Doing like those dominant things and bringing it home, but not saying like the woman can't do that either. The woman can do everything times 10.
Right.
And the bishop, you know, like he plays a role where, so what I studied in chess is basically they move like kind of like just different or whatever. And
well, they're the archers, just right down the diagonal.
And I feel like with this piece, that's how he actually moves. And to me, that's like my brother that lives here, you know, straightforward, kind of never looks back.
Right.
And the knight, another piece that pretty much like, it's also a woman who makes like more strategic moves.
Right.
But it's also straightforward with how she makes these moves and really like pays attention around her surroundings. The rook.
Side to side, up and down.
It's up and down, but also like the actual piece, what they say is not an actual castle, right?
Right.
But it looks like one.
Yes.
And to me, like Ace, that's his name and it's a character, he houses everybody in this unit. He takes in a lot of artists in St. Louis and really, I mean, in Oakland, California, and he really like, it's all about the artists. And like, he puts us in one place all together.
Beautiful and symbology, I like it. Yourself, you're the pawn. Now we hear in chess, you oftentimes sacrifice the pawn. Mm-hmm. So the pawn gets sacrificial lamb. But in the photo, you actually have a tear.
Yep. I have this tear falling from my eyes because of the sacrifices I feel like I made in my life to move forward, leaving St. Louis.
Right.
You know, I left a place where I actually love, I still do love,
right.
And I appreciate I learned a lot about the city. So it wasn't actually like, it was a good move on my half, I feel like, because I was able to do things like this and bring it back to the city and forever do that. But it was hard because I was leaving family behind.
Sure.
I was leaving friends behind and stuff like that. And not saying like they are still close to me, but at the same time, taken away from that, to this day, if a person that I love and even if I don't like know them straightforward, when they ask me specific questions on how I get here and how I make my moves, I tell them, you
right.
know? And I sacrifice a lot to for others, for them to move forward too.
That's
you know, I would give my last to somebody to move forward or whatever, and that's why I played the pawn. And you know, and if he's like I said, I was crying because it takes a lot out of somebody to give to somebody else
exactly.
to move forward
right.
and take away from. But yeah.
Adrian, I know you know you don't play chess, but it's quite extraordinary that for yourself, that in your picture of yourself, you chose the pawn to represent you, because in the game of chess, it's the pawn and only the pawn that can transform itself if it goes all the way to the black rank or the back rank. It can promote and become any piece other than the king. You can never become a mommy, you can never become the mother, but you can become a queen, a knight, a rook, or a bishop. It's interesting that you can transform yourself in your piece.
Yeah, I mean, it's just the, I just like the perfect fitting, you know?
Yeah.
And also like the look, the distinct look that I have going on inside of everybody looking into, if you look at the images, they look like they're looking at you, like looking
exactly.
back at you. So
exactly.
it's more so like, I wanted them to feel like they are actually here, even though they're back in Oakland.
Right.
I wanted them to feel like they're a part of this, being there, except the bishop, because I feel like the bishop focus is always straight.
Diagonally, yeah.
Right.
What drew you to Oakland? Huh?
Oakland. So I work for this company called Visco. It's an art and technology company.
Mm-hmm.
Stands for Visual Supply Company. And I'm an assistant editor and curator there in Oakland right now for them. Yep. So
cool.
I pretty much let's look through photos. And also, like I said, symbolically, it plays these parts in my lifetime, in my life, in the pieces. You know, the roles and how the pieces coincide with actual figures in my life.
Right.
Same thing. And it's powerful. It's a powerful game. And
for me, chess is really emotive. What I mean by that, Adrian, you and I can go to Forest Park down the street and race each other 100 meters. You might be faster than me. I can deal with that. No problem. And then, you know, we might decide who could climb the tree the fastest, and you might be better than me, and I can deal with that. But little kids, when they play the game of chess and they lose, they can't deal with, because
right.
it's like they're smarter, the other guy's smarter. And the whole point about chess, it's really about recognizing a lot of patterns. And the more experience in chess you have, the better you're going to play.
Right.
So I keep reassuring them that they're smart, you know, and that losing is simply a part of learning more, the process of getting more experience
right.
and seeing these patterns. So chess can be really right. emotive. I mean,
right.
people get mad when they lose,
that's life
you know.
Period, though.
Exactly.
With like learning
yeah.
how to do things, like
right.
taking pictures. I got better at taking photos, you know? Like, I
just
used to be,
right.
I look back at old stuff, I'm like, wow, I used to be trash with this, you know?
Yeah.
Like, this photo is horrible looking.
Right. Yeah.
Versus now it's like, you
oh,
know,
that's
with,
nice.
Right, like yeah. these photos here, it's like taken with medium format
right.
film. And I learned how to shoot on film. And the backstory behind this, I actually thought I rented a digital medium format camera. And I got the film and I was like, oh man, oof. Called Shannon, I was like, oh, We got something going on here. She's like, what are you talking about? I was like, I'm shooting film. She's
right.
like, whoa. Which is not a problem, but at the same time, I had a deadline. So if anything go wrong, I have five rolls of film six people to shoot.
Right.
You know, like, what the heck? So I made sure that everything turned out right.
Perfect.
And I look at, like, the sheets, and all the photos were great. So what took the longest was me narrowing down which images I'm just going to choose out of the bunch.
Exactly.
Because all of them came out pretty nice or whatever. So, and it's film.
Where's Adrian Walker going in the future?
Oof.
Oof.
Right now, it's more so definitely getting more into like conceptual work, work that tells like some type of story. All of my work, I feel like, has some type of meaning to it. Even the photos I take, just walking down the street, you know, I see something that catches my eye. It obviously tells some type of story.
Right.
I'm always attracted to something going on in my life, like something always going on while I'm in passing.
Right.
And I think it was just made that way, you know, it's made to be that way. So more so like right now, with my work is more so working towards more conceptual work, getting into museums, definitely. Printing more work, definitely. I found a love for curation. So like curating work also, me and my wife, she helped me curate a show back in San Francisco. So like.
Nice.
When did you know that, you know, chess was the game that you were going to pick up and stick with? When did you know this? Like at what age or like what time of your life?
Well, I started from the chess point of view late in life. A lot of the chess grandmasters and the world champions started at 5, 6, 7, and so on. I started at 12. Okay. So that was really late to pick up the game. But it was like, for me, the chess bug bit me, right? I was kind of intense. I was very competitive as a kid, a sports nerd, doing all of these different sports. And I was terrible, Adrian. No, I mean, seriously, I lost maybe my first 50 games I ever played in my life. And I was thinking, how can I be good at other things and so terrible in this thing, this activity, chess? And I think that I found really intriguing. Like, maybe I was a little bit of a contrarian, a rebel. I didn't like being told I wasn't any good at chess and people were beating me. And the guy who was really my first opponent, I said, well, how did you get good, David? And he said, the University of Washington in Seattle, they had a coffee shop there where all of the guys came and played chess with one another. So I went there. And they beat me worse than David.
Right.
Like, they're really whomping on me. So I came back home. This is about 3 months or so after I got into the game. And I said, well, that's it. I mean, I'm no good. And I said, okay, David, you know, one last game. And I made a bishop sacrifice, and I still remember it to this day. And I put his king in check with my queen, and his king had to go in the corner. And I checked him again with my queen, and the king had to come back. And we kept moving back and forth like this for a long time. You know, I said, well, I'm not letting you escape, but you can't get out. So what's that? We didn't know it was a draw, but we declared it a draw. We went beyond the three-move repetition rule. And I was like, wow, Mom, I got a draw. Which was the greatest victory, of course. Later, I turned 17. I graduated from high school a year early. And so I kind of had a sabbatical. So I could take a year away from my academic studies and see how far I could go with chess. I was pretty good, not great, but I was pretty good. And that year, I had all kinds of breakthroughs, which with each victory, if you will, inspired me to go more. And then it was somewhere during that year where everything was flowing really beautiful, traveling the world, playing in tournaments, I said, this ain't bad. I like doing this. I mean, I'll be a professional chess grandmaster. And that's where I think it was just literally after high school. Adrian, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure to meet you and talk with you. Everybody, come to the art exhibit. It's beautiful. 20 artists of St. Louis, including Adrian Walker's work. It's wonderful.